Today we will be demonstrating about inferior alveolar nerve block. The indications for inferior alveolar nerve block include any procedures performed on the mandibular teeth, that is right from the third molar to the incisor teeth. The anatomical landmarks for the inferior alveolar nerve block include
external oblique ridge, anterior border of the ramus, the deepest portion on the anterior border, that is the coronoid notch. Then we have the retromolar triangle, internal oblique ridge. These are all the bony landmarks. Soft tissue landmarks include the pterygomandibular raphe, the mucobuccal fold, and the buccal sucking pad.
The technique for the inferior alveolar nerve block. First, the chair position, where the patient is seated comfortably in the dental chair so that the mandible is at parallel to the floor.
And to open the mouth wide, either an index finger or the thumb can be used for palpating the landmarks. So we begin with palpating the mucobuccal fold in the premolar molar area. As we go posteriorly, we palpate the external oblique ridge. The external oblique ridge continues posteriorly as the anterior border of the ramus. On the anterior border of the ramus, the finger is moved in an up and down direction to locate the coronoid notch. The coronoid notch is the deepest portion on the anterior border of the ramus. This is a very important landmark in the inferior alveolar nerve block because this landmark determines the height at which the injection has to be given, because it is in line with the mandibular foramen. So we know that at coronoid notch height there is a mandibular foramen present. Next, the finger should not be moved in up and down direction. It can only be moved in a lingual or buccal direction. So we proceed palpating the retromolar triangle followed by palpation of the internal oblique ridge. Once we have palpated internal oblique ridge, then we move our finger buccally, still in contact with the retromolar triangle. Then 1 5 by 8 inches needle is taken and inserted from the opposite side of the mouth at the level of the occlusal plane, just lateral to the pterygomandibular raphe. The needle has to be inserted into the pterygotemporal depression and advanced till we hit the bone. So once we have hit the bone, we need to see how much of the needle has been inserted inside. Approximately half to 3/4 of the length of the needle should be inside when we contact the bone. If we hit the bone immediately after inserting, that means we have hit the internal oblique ridge. If we hit the bone and complete needle is inside the tissues, that means we are at the posterior border of the mandible. So ideally, only 1/2 to 3/4 of the needle should be inside when we have contacted the bone. In no condition, the solution should be deposited if we have not made any contact with the bone. So after the contact has been made with the bone, the needle is withdrawn 1 millimeter and aspiration is done in two planes. And 1 to 1.8 ml of the solution is deposited. Then the needle is withdrawn slightly and 0.5 ml of the anesthetic solution is deposited for the anesthesia of the lingual nerve.
The rationale behind this is the relationship of inferior alveolar nerve to the lingual nerve. The lingual nerve is medial and anterior to the inferior alveolar nerve in the pterygomandibular space.
After the local anesthetic is deposited, we have to wait for at least 5 to 10 minutes for the nerve block effect to take. After 5 to 10 minutes, the subjective symptoms can be checked on the patient on the lower lip on that side where the block is given. If you want to check subjective symptoms for the lingual nerve block, we ask the patient for numbness on the anterior two-thirds of the tongue on that side. Subjective symptoms can be elicited on the teeth anterior to the mental foramen, that is from the premolar or the anterior teeth.